Today, to have a cardiac surgical setup, you require minimum about 60 to 70 crores. You borrow that money, nobody puts his own money. Everybody takes money from the bank. Calculate the interest. Interest. You require 4 workers every day just to pay the interest. Forget about other things. Now, this is what is medicine all about. That is why the Ayurveda's definition says you must be a good fellow in all shastras. In the olden days, only wise people were admitted to the medical school in the Ayurveda. Not one who gets that CET rank. Today it's slowly changing. In the Brisbane University, they have found CET rank holders in physics, chemistry and biology, like very good technicians but very bad doctors. So now they take students from arts, music, literature, you know, anything, fine arts, and there they make very good doctors. So there's a move now in America to change their system to that of Brisbane. So in October in Orlando, we are discussing this also, another thing, how to take medical students into the medical college. Because you just can't take anybody and then train him and make him let loose on the gullible public to make life miserable for patients. I always tell my students, doctors cannot survive without patients, but patients can survive without doctors. So before the doctors are left and patients go away from you, you better change. Because if the patient doesn't come to you, what do you do? If nobody has a dental problem, what can you do? So, though we say we are here to keep health, we are here to keep disease. Box. This is called disease mongering. Do you understand that?
Box and create a dental problem.
Yes. And that's what I told you about New Zealand. Everybody had dental problem. Actually, to tell you very frankly, I used to go to Somayaji and all for some small things. He was a nice man. He had a clinic next to that Milagris Church. And you know, I was happy. Mohandas Nike, quite happy. 2 days dentist, you can't go, my God. They'll immediately say, okay, what is that? Root canal. So I was a vice chancellor, one day I had toothache. So, you know, as a vice chancellor, you can't be an ordinary, but they immediately take you to the senior post person there and say, sir, it is on the root canal. I didn't know what is root canal. I thought we were going to the root. So, every day, like that for about 3 months, went on and on and on. They temporarily filled something. Panpema, Satya. He should do that. Satya. So, I had a meeting in Goa. So, I had gone there in the hotel, I was sleeping at night. I thought a bomb had burst in my mouth. So, what to do? Suddenly, and again, you know, your wife said, so many people are there from the university. They said, oh, our dentist, right? Net, they got a dentist. They said, sir, this has to be removed, sir. Now I'll remove your filling. I said, okay, do what you like. Anyway, after that, I came to back to Manipal. They said, okay, this teeth has to be removed. I said, where did you do it in the first place? So, ever since that time, I've stopped going to dental services. joking. So, I'll tell you something very interesting. Today, we know. Tenkinenne. Coconut oil, you just put coconut oil in your mouth, 1 tablespoon of coconut. Don't tell this to your patients because you lose it. You can do that yourself. Just go on gargling the coconut oil and it should go through your teeth, crevices, etc., etc. And the whole thing will get digested there. Because coconut oil and mother's milk are the only two stuff in this world which can be digested in the mouth. Because salivary trypsin can digest coconut. Salivary lipase can digest the fat. And that's how the mother's milk and coconut oil having the same fat, monolauric acid, which is the most important base of human immune system. Now coconut oil has come back. 45 years ago when I wrote about coconut oil, people wanted to kill me. Today I'm very happy when I go to Seattle to see the headquarters of Costco. Half the building is coconut building. Today every house in America, they have coconut water. They don't eat cornflakes with cow's milk, coconut milk. I'm so happy.
So this is coming back slowly. So it is Mukaddi.
ಮನೆಗೆ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಕಡೆ ಹೋಯ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯು ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ in my diseases. You will be surprised. I have, touch wood, I have no problem with my tooth now because I gargle every morning with little coconut oil. And it's so fine. I have not seen a dental surgeon for a long time now. But sometimes I go to see, just to see, because my children, they'll say, you must get your teeth examined and things like that. Don't worry about that child, it'll be laughing. Coming back to the subject of health, you again must define health in such a way that the man doesn't have to go to a doctor for seeing whether he's healthy or not. So, according to Ayurveda, you can find out whether you're healthy or not without ever seeing a doctor or going to a laboratory. Now, if you go to a laboratory, what will happen? I'll tell you. I'll tell you, yes, you know what happens. You go to a checkup, then all the tests are done. TSH is slightly high. Everything is fine. You are fine. TSH is high. Immediately you are given Tylenol. Take this. But today we know TSH can be high or low for even normal people. Your PSA is high. You are told, oh, prostate, there is a cancer. Now at least government of America said, nobody's PSA test will be reimbursed by the insurance company because PSA test is fallacious, 100% fallacious. The minute you go in chest pain, you run on that machine, what's called GTT or treadmill. You know, it's so fallacious, the specificity and sensitivity of a treadmill test is less than 50%, which means whether it is positive or negative, it means nothing. It depends on the incidence of disease in the population. It's called Perloff's hyperbole. And if you know the Perloff is a professor of cardiology in Washington University. Perloff's hyperbole means if you are in Japan, if you have got a 100% positive test, it means nothing. If you are in Finland, if you are 50% positive, it means a lot because Finland 90% of the people are having coronary artery disease. So we simply do these things. Even today, everybody has done the TMT, I don't know why. But TMT machine is there. And in corporate hospitals, the management has a meeting and says, Mudita, your quota is so much. Looking at it in the last 3 months, you have not been very economically viable. That means you can go. So everybody is given a quota. So being a doctor in a corporate hospital is also stressful. Your blood pressure will go up. Because you're all the time looking at the quota.